Now, a matter of faith. Here's Steve Hartman.
At the start of the pandemic, Father Tim Pelk of St. Ambrose Catholic Church near Detroit had a problem. How in heaven's name was he going to sprinkle holy water on people's Easter baskets while maintaining social distance?
As you're pouring the holy water into the water pistol, are you saying, "Forgive me, Lord"?
Yes, there's a form of absolution that would go with that.
The pictures went viral last year, much to the delight of most people.
I know I had a couple of detractors in the clergy saying that this was sacrilegious to do it that way. And I said, guys, we're talking about chocolate bunnies and sausages here.
That's why this year he plans to go bigger.
No.
Not a bigger squirt gun, just more Easter baskets. And it's that kind of ingenuity we've seen across the country throughout the pandemic. From choir in your car.
Let my people go.
To Zoom Passover Seders.
I will not let them go.
We saw people bundled up in beach chairs and lots of praying behind the wheel. The drive-thru has been a real godsend to folks of all faiths. But even those who stayed home found ways to keep it special. Like 82-year-old Laverne Wimberly of Tulsa, Oklahoma, who still got dressed up to the nines every Sunday, always in a different outfit, just to watch her service on the computer.
It's kind of a reverence. You want to be respectful when you go to church, and primarily that's the reason why I continue.
You have all these clothes, and I see not one outfit is hanging up on the treadmill.
Absolutely not.
But Laverne says she is running out of closet space.
That's right. It cannot go another 52 Sundays, that's for sure.
Fortunately, there is much more hope this Easter weekend compared to last. Thanks to the vaccines, the renewal we celebrate in all our spring traditions feels especially profound. I felt that firsthand when my wife's parents, both fully vaccinated, came to visit us this past week.
Look at you!
It was the first time we'd seen them in over a year.
I love you.
Love you too.
And there's an Easter miracle we can all believe in.